Elizabeth, talk us through your beauty regime. Tell us your beauty tips.
So, just wear concealer under my eyes, down my nose, and on any spots. Then I just put bronzer all over my face so I look like I've been kissed by the sun even more than I have. My favourite bronzer is NARS Laguna. You can see it's very well loved and has been dropped many times. Then I fill in my eyebrows.
What do you mean? What does that mean?
Just like make them thicker and darker.
Do you like with a texter?
A texter?
Or with like a crayon?
Yeah, and then a gel thing.
I reckon it's so tough being a woman.
This is why I want to get that the microblades. You know, I was telling you about. You were like, that seems like a big.
Well, you cut your eyebrows, right?
Yeah. Well, it's like having them tattooed.
Yeah, that I told you about the story when Mum got her face tattooed. She looked like a clown when she came back.
Yeah, but like it's not. It isn't like that. It looks really. It would look like how they look once I filled them in.
Okay, and then it just saved time in the morning.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with that time?
Do some work.
There you go.
Most likely, that was eyebrows, and then I'm going to put on some highlighters that I glow from within.
Ooh, you do naturally. I thought that's what that vitamin C oil was for.
Just make your skin glowy. This one is by Hourglass.
That makes your skin glow?
The vitamin C serum, yeah.
What about this stuff you're chucking on your face now?
This is highlighter just for the tops of your cheeks.
Ooh. I reckon blokes should chuck a bit of this on.
That's more if you want.
Mm.
I'm not stopping you. I ain't stopping you. And then I'm just going to put a tiny bit of bronzer on my eyelids.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I like it.
I don't think I'm going to wear any mascara today, so I'm ready.
There you go.
That was nice and speedy. I'm just gonna wash my hands.
That's a first.
I always wash my hands off with my mama, you know, how do you know? We're working? It's cool.
It's cool.
What's the matter with you? What's that you got there?
Lizzie just made me a flower. Out of plastic.
Beautiful.
You never cease to amaze me, darling.
Thank you.
This is amazing.
I know.
That's art.
Yeah.
I've seen worse shit in the contemporary art museum. This is amazing.
And we got our coffees.
Loves it. Not hear that coming.
Silent bastard. How many times have you been to New York?
I think 6 times.
Oh, is this your 6th time?
Yeah. Yeah.
Me too as well, I think, actually.
Samesies.
I think it's my 6th time, yeah. Where were we the other day when you were like, oh, this is only the 2nd time I've been here or something? I thought it was here, or we were talking about somewhere. I don't know where I'm talking about.
No.
No, I've been everywhere more than twice.
I was not trying to be arrogant at all. This is Elizabeth's first time on a train. First time.
On a train, not these trains.
I'm proud of you.
No, the whole time I've lived in London, I've never got off the station.
What setting have you got this on? Where are we, darling? Tell me about it. Tell me about what you're seeing here.
He filmed people walking through New York and then shows the stills from it and created these cartoon-like images.
I really enjoy them, actually. Yeah. Almost as much as I enjoy you.
And my hair is still a mess.
Hey, your hair looks beautiful now. Because I fixed it.
What is this thing called?
This thing is actually called... It's called the Metal Heart, ladies and gentlemen. Installed in 2019, it actually resembles the beating heart of New York City. The artist really wanted people to get inside the arteries, inside the veins, and really feel that living heartbeat every single day of this amazing city. As you can see, there's an open structure in the middle, which signifies openness and willingness as a part of their mantra to early immigration laws. which they have now since kind of locked down, hence the cold, hard exterior, which the artist is actually trying to personify here in this beautiful sculpture.
What a load of shit. Ben is right there. Oh, we zoom in. So zoomed. I got you. You can see he's smiling.
The girl's getting it done.
Probably this. Oh, why aren't we there?
Ben's actually got the same one on in blue. I don't know if you realise it wasn't the same shirt.
I like it.
Did you realise though?
Yeah, why do you think I'm wearing it? So we can look really super cute and really uncomfortable and make people feel really awkward.
Some trousers which are new from Ray.
These are beautiful.
So good. My super gross trainers. I'm going to try and wash these, babe, when I get home.
You should. They're gross.
Celine Sunnies. Earrings from All Blues and Motley. Necklace from Rose of Holland and Roxanne First. And Penny and Croydon. Bag from Celine. Oh, Celine. Best Celine.
R.I.P. Celine.
Celine, gutted.
Oh, I like that. It's beautiful. Oh, do you think it's just a little bit loose?
Yeah, maybe it's okay for me a little bit loose. It makes that bit a bit longer.
It makes the split less pronounced. Oh, I like that. That's a sexy LBD, babe.
With my new big blazer.
Yeah, I like them.
I've got to wear some galactic in his head. I've got to wear a black dress. I don't know why yet.
It could work, yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't have noticed. The other one, is the other one the same size that you just tried on?
No, smaller.
This is a success, darling. I think so. So what have you got here? What'd you get? Nice. Oh, they're so pretty. Should we go?
Yeah. We're running late for dinner and drinks because Ben was cleaning my trainers. The rubbery bits. What a hero. Don't you?
You are so welcome.
Got my new dress on from Ref. Ben's wearing trousers, shoes from
Vega.
Vega. Trousers from Cos. Top from
Project Amsterdam.
Project Amsterdam. And we're going for drinks and dinner now.
We are, it's going to be fantastic.
It's going to be absolutely fantabby dozy.
Do you want me to show you? I think everyone should see this.
Okay, it's completely out of focus, but we'll see what happens. Watch that.
I missed almost the car.
Elizabeth. Hi. How are we doing? Oh, girl. Were you an emo when you were growing up?
A little bit.
Really?
I'm always so into music. That was part of it. I went through a bit of emo phase where I was into like really pop punk bands, like Cute Is What We Aim For.
What is that?
We'll listen to it.
Okay, look forward to
Taking
that.
Taking Back Sunday.
Yep.
And then I got more into heavy stuff like Nirvana, and then was obsessed with anything.
So there's some gateway bands to get you into something a little bit heavier.
Yeah.
What about Evanescence?
Evanescence.
Schweppes brand.
I was never into them, no. Not them. But yeah, I was a bit emo-y. In the MySpace days.
MySpace?
Yeah.
That's taking me back.
I loved MySpace.
Surprisingly, was so good at it.
Right, surprisingly.
Well, no, not surprisingly, because I expect everyone to be like,
okay.
So next one?
Next one.
I'm ready. Yeah.
I didn't come up with any, but no. We totally can.
If we win. Last time when the questions, nobody was focused on the questions.
Describe your
basket.
Oh my god!
Or carnival. Whichever way. An extra hot party with scotch bonnet and friends.
I like
yellow
scotch
chili
bonnet.
Peppers, yeah. Green mango, thyme, and ginger. This delicious
mango.
Sauce will get you dancing in the streets. Our homegrown yellow peppers lime juice and tropical herbs and spices keep you swaying. Turn any meal into a celebration in just a few drops.
Right. You should be the spokesperson, girl.
Who's ready to party?
I'm ready to party. Those chili peppers, habanero peppers.
She's
like it. Shit. You really don't know that.
Sorry, I'm gonna regret that.
Spicy, pun intended.
Such a bold choice.
Amazing chili.
Well. You got
a dollop.
Get
I'm
in
doing
there.
Like,
check it in there.
Check it in there, bro.
Check it in there, bro.
I'm doing
it. Okay. This is a good covering.
Oh yeah, that's what's
right
up.
That's
okay.
Oh, that's a lot.
It's not bad. I actually think we've regressed. It's fine.
Okay.
I actually think we've regressed. It's just fine.
That's hot.
Just waiting for an afterburn.
It's true.
I feel
like a little bitch.
1, 2, 3.
Wait.
My lips.
There's a bubble of vodka
here.
I flex my lips.
It's like breathing in and out is so
stopping
bad.
Drinking makes it go quicker.
Have some normal chicken with just like
promise.
A nice, yeah. Nice
for a bit.
Like,
try
you're
to
lying.
Minute. No, I'm not.
Don't
I swear.
Don't
try for a second. Try for a second.
You know when you get like cramp in your
a bit longer. Can I keep trying?
Yeah.
Not drinking.
What's up? Hey there, and what's happening?
Tell you what, you give Biggie Smalls a run for his money.
I am Biggie Smalls.
What have you done today, darling?
Had breakfast in bed, then went out and brought back a coffee and a bagel for Mus and Daughters. 10 boyfriend points.
Only 10?
Well,
ten's a lot.
You never
I was
get 10. At any given time.
Really?
I would never give more than 10.
Right, okay. Good to know, because I've been giving you like 20 points here and there.
Good, though. This is good. And then we've come out and had a coffee, and we're walking to a shop for you.
Yep.
Saturdays. We went into one of them, but they didn't have some things, so we're going to the other one. And then this afternoon, we're going to Connecticut.
Connecticut,
which I'm looking forward to.
Be nice.
How are you feeling? We're a bit weird today.
In the sense of, we
can't make sentences.
Yeah, Elizabeth told this story, which was genuinely the most boring thing I've ever had to listen to.
And I knew it was boring the whole time, and I was thinking, I can't redeem this story in any way.
So then she just made. So then she was just like, and I was in a coma for 6 weeks, and I was like, now it's getting interesting.
I did not say that.
What did you say?
I was on crutches.
You're on crutches. All I heard was, I was in a coma for 6 weeks, and I was like, give me the popcorn. You got me. I'm back in.
Yeah, we feel a bit weird today. Do you know what solved me, and this is the problem with drinking every day? A Bloody Mary is what would fix me.
We can go get a Bloody Mary.
But then you just carry on
the
drinking.
Cycle.
I know,
yeah, you're right.
It's so bad. But maybe we should do it while we're here, because we'll break out of it when we're home.
This is true. All right.
Let's go get a Bloody Mary.
Bloody Marys.
Happy Easter.
You get some Easter eggs.
Oh, I'd love an Easter egg.
I've taken us the wrong way, I'm sorry.
Here is the Easter egg.
Pizza.
Ooh.
Should we
no
go in?
Way. No, not
pizza.
Easter egg.
No,
this way. Yeah, Easter egg is my favourite time of year.
Oh, I fucked it.
Oh. So good. Just going for a bit of everything, I hope you don't mind.
So good. My legs are there, so you can take it over that way.
Got it.
Nailed the landing.
Got it.
So we're taking Lizzie to the Whispering Wall in Grand Central. She's not done it before.
Why is it called? Is this what the eagle's leaning up against it for?
Yeah, so basically, I'm going to stand at this end here, you're going to stand at the other end, and we're going to chat to each other and face the wall. Alright?
So we stand at opposites?
Yeah.
In
that's Lizzie. Alright, we're going into the Whispering Wall.
Elizabeth, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
It's mental, isn't it?
Oh my gosh, you can hear. Say something else. Yeah, is this because of the way it like, reverberates up the arch?
I don't know, you sound very northern. I can't understand what you're saying when you're northern.
Oh, can you hear me better? How do you speak normally?
I'm gonna head back now,
baby. Okay, I'll see you in the middle.
See you in the middle.
So we're now waiting for Elizabeth to pick her outfit. It's been a little while now. This doesn't usually happen to her. It's a bit of a one-off. So I guess we're about to see what's about to happen now.
Here's the carnage. What do we think?
I'm having a really bad morning.
Okay. What don't we like about this? Ooh.
I think I do like this.
It's a nice jacket, I like that.
But then you're not meant to wear it like this, really. You're meant to wear it like
bit more open.
But I like it at the top when you can wear it like this too.
Yeah.
But I like it like this.
That's cool. And what shoes? Your Brogues?
No.
No?
They hurt me on the first day, didn't they?
They hurt you emotionally.
I think Converse, but do you think if this doesn't look too boxy, because it looks cool, I've got my hand in my pocket.
Yeah, take your hand out. Yeah. What are you worried about?
Looking too boxy.
I mean, it does look a bit boxy.
But in a cool boxy way or in like a...
I'm not colour? I shouldn't be the authority on what cool boxy looks like. Do you know what I mean?
I do, but you know what looks nice or what you think looks nice.
Yeah, but I think this looks great.
Okay, I'll put my Converse on.
Yeah, girl.
We got it.
Get it.
We there?
Yeah.
Celine bag. And we got it. High five.
It's meant to be the world's best chocolate, according to Gigi.
What? No,
it's pretty good.
It tastes like a Magnum or something.
Oh, it's so good.
That's the best chocolate in the world.
That is actually really good.
That's
very
good.
Smiley.
Oh my god, I want to just like...
You can't...
So nice. Do you?
Yeah.
I'm not.
Towards the Brooklyn Bridge, we walked past the Brooklyn Bridge.
Over it.
Do you like that?
It's beautiful.
I'm a poet and I didn't even know it.
Do you know it?
Do know it.
Smooth. Smooth. Matching our white shirts.